Hello, Patrick Walchuk here with an update on the Ottawa real estate market to the end of August 2023. And if you enjoy getting these videos, hit the subscription button, the notification bell, and we'll send them out to you every 30 days. So looking at what went on in Ottawa in August, starting with residential homes, the number of actual sales was about flat with last year. We had 528, when I say residential, that's anything other than a condominium, 528 of them trade hands. Now the good news is that the average price was almost $770,000, which was an increase of 4.2%. Now if you recall, last year we're kind of on this downward slope after March of last year, and we'll show you what's happening this year, but anyhow, we're up compared to August of last year. The number of active listings is about 3,105. To put that into context with the number of sales that we've had, but you know, combining both res and condo, we have approximately an 18.5-week supply of inventory on the market, which means it's slightly in seller's territory. To be a balanced market, we need about 21 to 24-week supply. So anyhow, that puts a little context number on the existing inventory. And in terms of how long it's taking for a home to sell, they were selling in 26 days. So moving on to condominiums, again, almost flat with last year. We had 263 sell, which is a decline of about 2.5%. The average condo price in Ottawa last month was $436,000, an increase of 1.7%. The number of condos on the market, we currently have 592 of them for sale. And in terms of how long they were taking to sell, they're selling in a few days less than last year, in 26 days compared to 29. So let's take a look at exactly what's gone on month over month this year, because the numbers we just showed you are comparing this month of this year to the same month of last year. So you can see that for the first few months of the year, we were increasing in price, increasing. Then we had a couple of months where we had slight declines. Then we had a little bump up in July of 2.6%. And in August, we had a decline of about 5.5%. So the interesting thing here is going to be what's going to happen in September, because what I've been reading is that Canada's had a softening of its GDP levels and a softening of our employment levels, meaning unemployment is increasing. So when we have these two negative factors taking place, how will that in fact impact the September numbers? And then the other thing is that's sort of in opposition to what usually happens in Ottawa, where we have a traditionally strong market in September. And for example, last September, we had a jump up in prices compared to August after all those months of decline. So it'll be interesting to see with the weakening economy, supposedly, versus our traditionally strong market, what happens. But what we saw happen again in August was a decline of about 5.5%. And thank you for watching this video.